I think it's just the wildness and ability to be on your own in a dramatic landscape. And it's just breathtakingly beautiful. Mostly one feels like a small boy being released into a lolly shop or something similar, because it has that feeling. You're just so pleased to be back. I grew up in South Africa, and I grew up in a city on the high central plateau called Pretoria. And I spent all of my childhood, boyhood youth in Pretoria. I was interested in the living world. I mean, many kids are. So they start being fascinated by insects, and it seems my fascination just continued, so I didn't grow out of it. One of the professors in the entomology department said, oh, you'll never learn anything at university. What you have to do is you have to start going into the field to do research. And so, to the horror of everyone, my parents, friends, I stopped my degree at the end of my second year and went to the sub-Antarctic, to an island called Marion Island, which is about 2,500 kilometres southeast of Cape Town. I went there for the first time as a field assistant. Lots of my research has been about basic discoveries. So there's field science, where you're sampling things and trying to get a handle on the variation by trying to measure all the things that might have an influence. But in the lab, you often keep everything constant and change one variable, then you understand what its impact is. So what we do in the lab is we're trying to understand what the absolute limits are to growth at the high and the low ends, and activity at the high and low ends for these species. So we bring the animals, in this case mostly springtails, and then we grow them here through one generation, so that any influence that the outside world may have had on them to begin with, we reduce to being more or less equivalent in the lab. And then we test them for how fast they grow and what their limits to activity are. Because when it gets too warm, they fall over. If you cool them down again, they get back up again, so that's not a bad news story. And if they get too cold, of course, they just stop moving. Some of the springtails that we've worked on, if you warm them up, the invasive ones become more resistant to dry conditions. But the indigenous ones show the opposite, they become less. So climate change will probably make things really much worse for the indigenous ones and really much better for the invasive ones. And of course, we're applying all of those principles to understand a range of organisms as to what might change into the future and how we can cope with that change. One of the things with research is you can have a direction, I want to solve this problem. But another one that's really good is that things surprise you. So you scratch the surface of something and it turns out to be quite different to what you thought it might be. Really, there's still a lot of freedom to pursue your research interests in the path that they take you. So that, for me, the exploration of the natural world, is actually a goal. I'm just interested in the way the world works. I'm prepared to spend lots of time on trying to use that to develop solutions for problems that we're causing. Well, I'm an optimist, so I don't say, oh, well, you know, we're going to hell in a handbasket. Let's just make sure the handbasket's comfortable. I rather think, let's try to slow it down a little.